Welcome to next Adash video. I want to talk about balancing and the ISO 1940 standard. I know it is replaced by the new standard 2-1940. Now it contains more older standards in one. The text from ISO 1940 is just copied to 2-1940 standard. The text of 1940 standard is quite difficult to read. I am sure that many of you tried to read it and you gave it up. In this video, I try to simplify the text. What is the balance quality? It is what the standard describes. Usually all of us use the vibration level as balance quality. If vibrations are low, then we are satisfied. But the standard uses other concept. For example, we have rotor with zero unbalance. I mount the mass to some position. The question is, can I run and use this machine with this heavy spot? Is it the unbalance acceptable for safe run? By other words, I would like to know how massive the heavy point can be to allow the machine be running. By next other words, what is the acceptable or permissible residual unbalance? To obtain a satisfactory running of the rotor, the residual unbalance URS should not be higher than a permissible value U pair. What is the unit for U pair? The SI unit is kilogram times meter, but more practical is gram times millimeter. I will explain it later. It describes the heavy spot. It tells us that specific mass is mounted on specific radius. On the picture, you can see the rotor. Here is the heavy spot mass, 100 grams. The radius is 500 millimeters. The U pair is equal 100 times 500. It is 50 thousandths gram millimeters. Note that the same value of U pair we get with 200 grams on 250 millimeters or 50 grams on 1000 millimeters. When the rotor is running, then the centrifugal force is created. And this force hurts us. It causes bearing damage. The formula is this. Force F is equal mass M times radius R times square of angular velocity omega. You can see that double mass doubled the force. The double radius also doubled the force. The omega is the speed. You can see the square of that. It means 2 times higher speed creates 4 times higher force. Now, short explanation of radian. When we talk about angles, we use the degrees as the unit. You know that the circle has 360 degrees. You can say that one rotation has 360 degrees. But also radian unit exists for angle value. One rotation is 2 times p radians. Now we know that one circle has 360 degrees or 2 times p radians. You can simply derive that one radian is equal 57.5 0.3 degrees. Now you know that we have two units for angle measurement, the degree and the radian. The omega is angular velocity. The radian per second is the unit. It is rotation speed. We use the speed in hertz usually. It is the number of rotations per second. And we can easily convert the angular velocity omega to hertz. The formula is that omega is equal to 2 times p times frequency in hertz. One rotation omega is equal to 2 times p. When we need f rotations per second, then we must multiply it by f. Now about the relation of permissible residual unbalance and the rotor mass. Look at rotor on picture. For example, the permissible residual unbalance is 100,000 grams millimeter. I can recalculate it to 100 gram meter. Now I add the same next rotor to this one. This new one has the same individual permissible residual unbalance. It's clear that 2 times heavier rotor has 2 times higher permissible residual unbalance. In general, for rotors of the same type, the permissible residual unbalance U pair is equal E pair times rotor mass in kilograms. We must multiply the E pair by mass. The E pair is permissible residual unbalance for the rotor with 1 kilogram mass. The E pair is called permissible residual specific unbalance. Now look again to rotor on the picture. It has the geometrical center just in the middle of the circle. When it is perfectly balanced, then also center of gravity is in the same position. Now I add heavy spot. The center of gravity moves. I can measure the distance between geometrical center and the center of gravity in micrometers. That it is the reason why we use these units for E pair. We can work with this fraction. Kilogram is equal 1000 times gram. Now we can shorten the grams. We get millimeter divided by 1000. And it is the micrometer. It means the E pair is the permissible distance between geometrical center and the center of gravity in micrometers for a rotor mass 1 kilogram. We are used to using RPM or hertz for speed, not the radians, which is better for calculations. The circumference of circle with radius 1 is 2π. When the speed is 1 hertz, then this 2 times p rotation must be done in 1 second. It means the angular speed omega is equal to 2p. When speed is higher, then the angular speed omega is equal to 2p times speed frequency in hertz. And what about the rotor speed? The ISO 1940 standard tells this. Experience shows that for rotors of the same type, the permissible residual specific unbalance value, E pair, varies inversely with the speed of the rotor. It is not derived just from experience. This corresponds exactly to the laws of physics. Differently expressed, this relationship is given by the following equation. E pair multiplied by omega is constant value. It means for 2 times higher speed, we get 2 times lower permissible residual specific unbalance E pair. The question is, how big is the constant value? This is the table of rotor types. The high precision machines are on the bottom. They require very low permissible unbalance. On the top are large slow speed machines like marine diesel engines. These allow a high permissible unbalance. The balance quality grade is created for every rotor type. The grade is letter G and the value of permissible residual specific unbalance E per multiplied by omega and divided by 1000. For example, for most standard machines, the G6.3 grade is used. It means that E per multiplied by omega and divided by 1000 is equal 6.3. You can see that for bigger machines, the E per omega increases. It means more heavy unbalance is allowed. In this graph, we can find the permissible residual specific unbalance for every rotor type and the speed value. For example, we have machine grade G6.3 and speed is 3000 RPM. We draw the vertical line from 3000 RPM on x-axis up to the G6.3 line. From the intersection, we draw the horizontal line to the y-axis. We read the value of intersection with y-axis. It is 20 gram millimeter per kilogram. What is the practical procedure? We have machine with G6.3 balance quality grade. The speed is 1000 RPM. From the graph, we find the E per is 60 grams millimeter per kilogram. The rotor mass is 100 kilograms. The permissible residual unbalance U per is E per times rotor mass. It is 60 times 100. It is 6000 grams millimeters. For better understanding, we transfer the 6000 grams millimeters to 6 gram meter. And now the practical example. The rotor parameters I define in rotor settings menu. It is rotor mass in kilograms. It is correction radius in millimeters. In this radius, we mount balancing mass and the required quality grade. The initial residual unbalance we know after trial run. It is the mass which we should mount to specified radius to balance the rotor. It is on the opposite side of the heavy spot. This screen appears after trial run. I can display, for example, this. The residual unbalance is 11.5. It is too high. Permissible unbalance is just 0.02. It means that we should balance this rotor. This is the initial grade 12.1. It is higher than required grade 6.3. We should balance. This is another example of screen after trial run. You can see initial residual unbalance. It is 5. It is less than permissible unbalance, which is 6.02. There is no need to balance this rotor. This is the initial grade, 5.24. It is less than required grade, 6.3. We don't have to balance. Now I show you the balancing process with Adash VA5 analyzer. Firstly, I enter the rotor parameters. Mass is 100 kg. Radius is 500 mm. And quality grade is G6.3. The initial values are 10 mm per second the amplitude and 0 degrees the phase. Now we should mount the trial mass. The recommended trial mass is 96.3 grams. I have the 100 grams mass and I will use it. How the instrument get that value? You can see the formula for U-pair. It is permissible residual unbalance. It is 12 grams on half meter radius. We use trial mass, which is 8 times higher. The trial run values are 20 millimeters per second and phase 0 degrees. Now you can see that initial unbalance is 50 grams meters. Permissible value is 6. Initial quality is 52.4. Required grade value is 6.3. Values are red colored. It is clear we must balance. We have mounted the required mass and we measure again. On the next screen we can see that values are green colored and are below the permissible values. And that is all. Thank you for watching, and you can add questions or comments to this video.